All right, Bob, it is time to get to it. We all love trick-or-treating. We all love trick-or-treating as kids. We all love taking our kids trick-or-treating. We all love handing out candy. It is time for Bob's worst things to get trick-or-treating power rankings. Here we go.
Let's all feel the power. It's time for power rankings with Mikey and Bob on 96.1 KISS.
Brought to you by our friends at C. Harper Auto Group.
All right, now this is not the worst candy power ranking because that is a totally separate power ranking that we'll get to. This is just the five worst things that you could get trick-or-treating because we all know that every neighborhood has a person that is going to go just, they are not going to understand the assignment and they are going to put something awful in your kid's trick-or-treat bag, right? Bob, number five, worst thing to get trick-or-treating.
Pencils.
Number four.
Change.
By the way, just what are we doing with change in general now? Like, just get it all out of here. Can we just outlaw change? Why are we still making change? Like, is the government, is the U.S. Mint, are we still printing pennies? And
like, I get it, you're participating in Halloween,
you're
but
not,
are you?
Though.
Are
you? No, you're not, though. If you're not giving out candy, you're not really participating. Just shut your light off is what you should have done. Especially if you're giving out pennies. Like, what is that, like a last minute sort of Hail Mary, just like, I forgot that it's Halloween? Or, you know, I mean, neighborhoods do different trick-or-treating now. Maybe it's not Halloween. It might be the night before or the Saturday before. So maybe it's just like, oh my gosh, you hear the kids trick-or-treating and your light's on and you freak out and you're just like, well, I have these roll of pennies. Like, how does it happen? Does anybody consciously go into Halloween just going, I'm going to be the penny house? You shouldn't. All right, number three, Bob, worst thing to get trick-or-treating.
Cough drops.
What is that? Who's doing it?
It's the worst. Nobody wants that.
Well, it's not the worst. It's not the worst, though, because it's only number three. So there's two things that are worse, Bob.
That is true. We're pretty bad, though. We're pretty bad here.
I also wonder how cough drops happen, too. Is that just an older person who maybe has lost some of their, lost some of their mind in old age and thinks it's candy? Number two, worst thing to get trick-or-treating, Bob.
Toothbrush.
I feel like that's just a dentist being funny. It's somebody that works at a dentist office. They have access to the product, and I feel like they are just flexing their profession on Halloween.
You gotta throw candy with it, though. You gotta throw candy with it.
Okay, they look at the bag already full of candy, and they're thinking, I have to do something to counteract this. I feel like that is all dentists. It's people that work in the dental profession. It's them.
Kids aren't looking for an LOL on Halloween.
No, They're not. All right, and here we go. It's the worst possible thing to get trick-or-treating. Number one, Bob.
Some type of religious pamphlet.
Yeah. Boom, boom, yeah. Woo! Okay.
Let go.
You should call the police on those people, right?
Levels of this, and like, really, it's all the way up here. It's all the way up top.
It's the any sort of pamphlet. Why is that? And I also feel like that is an older person too. I feel like it's an old granny whose husband passed 35 years ago. She's on her own. She's alone, and nobody tells her what to do. She goes to church multiple times a week. She's really religious. Nothing wrong with that, granny. Right? There is something wrong though with you handing out religious material on Halloween to the kids, though, right?
It just doesn't fit. It's not there for the kids are there for the treats, granny.
It's true. And it's the worst possible thing, Bob. There you go. That is the worst possible thing to get Halloween trick-or-treating. Worst things to get trick-or-treating power rankings. This isn't worst candy. That is a separate power ranking. These are just the things that you get when you're trick-or-treating and you just go, what the hell? Like, why would you do this to me? You can't just get candy? Why are you giving this to me? Number five might be a shocker, Bob. It's very specific. Number five worst thing to get trick-or-treating. I'm going not Doritos, not Fritos, regular chips. Nobody wants regular chips on Halloween. Wow. Plus, the other thing is, if you're doing trick-or-treating correctly, you are going to have you know, a few pounds of candy. And if you get those chips early in the night, they are going to be completely crushed by the other candy. It's not a good snack. The regular chips, just get them out of here. They're going to get crushed by the candy. And when you got all your candy on the floor after you're done trick-or-treating and you see a bag of chips, nobody gets excited for that. When you have a Halloween bowl that you have, like, you know, in the kitchen or something like that, that you're picking at a week after Halloween, it's always the chips that are still sitting in there. No one wants the regular chips. Listen, if you got something like Doritos or Fritos or something a little fancier, sure. Regular chips, though, you're hot. Get them out of here. Number four, raisins. What are you doing? Raisins. Like a box of raisins, right? Like, Granny's giving out a box of raisins. She is. Get them out of here. Number three, apples. My last two, I'm just anti-health on Halloween is what I'm going for here. It's just, those are houses that are trying. They're trying.
I'm participating. They're I'm like, here.
You know what? I got something for the kids. It's a little something to break up the candy. A box of raisins, right? And it's always the little red box. What's that company called? Is it,
Sunmade?
Sunmade. Is that what it is? Is it Sunmade raisins? It's always the little red box. Is it Sunmade raisins? Is that what it is? It is. Sunmade raisins. You always see the lady with the bonnet on, the Sunmade raisins. Nobody wants that when they're trick-or-treating. And apples. I don't even need to go into it. Just
a little something to break up the sweets, you know?
Nobody wants the apples. Number two, it's change. Again, why are we even producing change anymore at this point? And who thinks that a kid is going to get incited because you gave him a quarter for Halloween? You know, like, that's a pretty dangerous thing too, because you spread all your stuff out, your trick-or-treating candy, that little nickel, that dime could easily be ingested by a smaller sibling or a pet, you know? It's a dangerous thing.
Danger.
Change on Halloween. Number one, though, Bob, I agree with yours. It's the worst thing to get trick-or-treating. It's any sort of pamphlet or information at all. I almost feel like the police should be called on those people. If you're handing out any sort of pamphlet on Halloween, you did not understand the assignment. Some parent should confront you and just ask you why you're doing this, and you
just
should
turn the light off.
Turn the light off. Exactly. So we're both in agreement here. The worst possible thing to get trick-or-treating is if someone is giving, I don't know if they're religious. I don't know if they're like, you know, stay off of drugs or something. Just, I'm going to give the kids a little piece, a little something of knowledge, right?
Here.
Any sort of pamphlet, paper information that you can get trick-or-treating is the worst possible thing that you can get.